The path of glory! It takes us here to the United Center in Chicago, Illinois! And tonight is a returning special night for CXWI. We are part of CAW Oktoberfest! Look at that! Skull, UCCW, CAW Cade. All of these events happening in the month of October, and we are a part of it. But this is the first time that CXWI has been a part of something like this. So, we've got to deliver. I'm Elabob1, I'm joined here by JSR.
Hello. And the fact is CXW management put a risk by putting me on commentary. You're fucked up already, and it hasn't even taken, not even that long.
Well, don't worry about it. Well, anyway, we're kicking it off with women's action. This, of course, followed what happened on Open Fight Night in Spain. Crazy Amy Blazargo, as you see here in the ring. She wanted action. She was confused as to why she wasn't on the card. It had to be explained to her. She had to call someone out. She called out Kitanga, who at that point hadn't scored a single victory in CXWI. But that would change when Kitanga would defeat Crazy Amy in Spain. Amy Blazargo, being the crazy bitch that she is, attacks Kitanga following it and challenges her to this match we have right now.
Great.
Yep. Not to mention, once again, referencing the fact that we are part of CAW Oktoberfest. These two women have the pressure of opening the night for us.
It would have been a whole lot easier if I was fully cleared to compete. I would open the show with one hell of a match with whoever.
Well, normally you say you're going to have one hell of a match and then you end up being beaten in no less than a minute.
Oh, don't bring that back up.
Well, anyway, Kitago in. And this is mono and mono action to kick off the night.
That's more of a joke than saying...
Oh, this might be over early! Not the first time, but Crazy Amy would have been beat by a schoolboy cover. Or schoolgirl cover, excuse me.
Need anyone remind about Samus?
Samus, that, of course, will be defending the women's title later tonight in T-Bone's Rules against the mysterious creature simply known as Buka. Also tonight, our main event, the world title, Jack Stambridge defends against the Path of Glory series winner. That's of course being the undefeated Dasan. The international title also up. Miss Monto defends against the EXE virus, Sonic.
And the good news is, I found out my what was causing me to freeze up.
What?
Fully. It's because of the fact that my medication...
Well, are you sure it wasn't the fact that we weren't moving? Remember everyone, movement makes me move.
Oh, God. You're not going to let that go.
No, I'm not. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, also following up after this match will be the Tag Team God Online in Hardcore Rules, as it will be Tag Champions Austin Nuaz and ME defending against the New Regime. And you see right now, nicely caught there by Amy and not a pile driver. What the fuck am I saying? That's a jawbreaker. Although she did pile drive. Just did pile drive Kitanga right into her, right on her jaw, right on her head. And you see right now, score buyers. Amy Blazargo was spending more time just flipping out and having a hissy fit again.
That's pretty much usual.
Yep. You see, and Amy Blazargo going up to the top!
But I tell you what, the match that might make the impact is Sebulba versus Anakin Skywalker.
Of course, that one, it is faction versus hair. If Skywalker wins, the Republic has to disband. If Sebulba wins, then Skywalker loses his hair.
I've been in the hair versus hair match in CXWI. This is only the second ever time that
someone's hair has been on. Actually, when you technically think about it, when Zoloark and Lucario faced the Hyperlink Revolution, they had technically had their body fur on the line, so that technically counts as hair.
Okay, so that means this is the third
ever. There, right to the head by Amy Blazargo, and Amy right now seems to have Kitanga right in control.
Because the very first one involved me and my brother, which I won.
And he didn't even shave his hair completely.
Yeah.
You just left him with a very weird bald patch.
Then he got his revenge and shaved my head bald.
I remember that.
Yeah.
That was in the early days. That was the first ever CXWI Golden Ambitions as Katanga there hits a suplex. Katanga right now. Ah, there you go.
What a kick. That should finish this off. One,
she's finished it. She finished off Amy last time with a kick. Ooh. Oh, wait a minute. I don't think... Oh, I think she wants to give her another one. I think she wants to give her...
Don't waste time.
Here it comes. Oh, it gets caught.
I told you. Don't waste time.
Amy blows up. Oh, I'm going to push you down and now to the top. Splat. No.
Missed it.
You didn't get it that time. And now, he gets caught again that time. Oh! With an insiguri!
Good way to capitalize on a mistake of waiting.
She gets caught with that. Amazon catches the super kick, but she ends up being clobbered with the insiguri kick.
Well, anyway, Bizarro got tossed around like a ragdoll with the hair.
Oh, and now she's gonna.
Another kick.
She's gonna tune it up and. Oh! She gets caught again! That time she got. Both of them there swinging and missing. Oh, but there you go.
Nice kick.
And Katanga once again. Oh, nice shot there. And caught again. That's how she catches that. Whoa! Nice. And Katanga now. There you go.
That should finish this match off.
The kick right to the
one,
right to the
two,
chin
two.
Of Amy Blazaga, and there you go. Katanga getting another victory.
She's now getting herself on the roll. She could have a chance. Could have a shot.
She's really starting to turn it up a bit.
Well, I tell you what, this is going to be an interesting night.
And this is just how we've kicked it off.
But I tell you what, one of the most heated matches.
Look at that.
Coming up right next, and that is the tag team titles. That should be interesting.
Certainly should be. And that will be a. Wait a minute. But we're going to the back end. Sektor's been. Wait a minute. Oh my. I don't know if you can see this, but if we can get a better zoom in, it looks like. Look at his head! His head has been completely mangled!
Oh my god.
What the heck has happened? What the? Sektor has been... I think I know why the other members of the Republic are here, but... Sektor was... What did he look back there? He looked like he was completely... Well, his head looked like it'd been crushed or something.
Well, anyway, moving on.
Well, the night's continuing. We're going to need to get some info on...
Well, we're getting the medical team right down there right now.
But... It just looked like his head had been completely... Either crushed or... Just his... Head was just completely defigured, almost. Just looked creepy. Well, anyway, here is... Could have got a. Just wish the camera team would have got a better angle on it, but regardless.
Anyway,
the tag gold will be on the line.
This should be interesting, to say the least.
There will be hardcore rules as. Well, this has been really a pretty heated up, particularly with the new regime and the level of just animosity that they've created. Across the world, just the way that they, just their attitude towards everything has just been absolutely just vile.
Say that again, it's just absolutely nasty.
Of
anyway.
Course, it goes back to the Night of Champions. I believe it goes back to the Night of Champions night in Japan when they took on the Brotherhood. They won themselves the rights to be the number one contenders for the tag gold. But just their behaviour in Japan was absolutely disgusting. And then later that same night in which Mewtwo was addressing the CXWI fans on his condition, the new regime had the audacity again to not just show up and try to make themselves look bigger than CXWI and bigger than Mewtwo. But not only that, they're still not really known about Mewtwo's hard condition at that time, and they still attacked him.
Absolutely ridiculous.
Of course, Osnewes and Emmy ended the night by putting those two in their place. And once again, I feel I should elaborate. I as a commentator should not try to show bias, but I am praying that Osnewes and Emmy kick the shit out of the new regime.
Agreed. But the question is, at the moment, what is the physical state of Mewtwo? What is the physical state of Tails?
Well, that was, of course, one of the other things brought up in Japan. As far as I know, last time I seen it up there, Mewtwo has now gone, he's actually gone into one of his, like, personal hideout homes. And he's on the road to recovery there. And as far as I've heard, Tails is in another hospital. But as to what his condition is, I haven't received any word. This is the real deal, not a test. Now society is... Alright, here comes the new regime. Get down on the ground, put the earth
to your ear. You feel that sound? New regime, you care. What? The greatest battle of all time. What the heck is that? Targeted by our own kind. Are they worse than the ball? In the ball arrived.
They're pretty close, and then again, that's pretty much you'd say, are they worse than? You were at one point a part of it. Anyway, here is Phil Meade, the ultimate definition of the phrase traitor. The ultimate meaning of, the ultimate representation of just the word vile. I mean, this goes back to when he was suspended following his behavior on the base of operations. And then he comes back, he betrays us to you as... And then he takes this young talent, Ben Masters. And, you know, when Ben Masters first came here, he was a pretty... He looked to be one of the biggest up-and-comers, wrestling skills-wise. But he just gets ruined by his attitude, and the attitude he's adopted from Phil Meade. Once again, I elaborate, but it is just unfortunate. Remember, this is hardcore rules tag action, meaning it is tornado style rules, and as you can see, there's weapons.
I'm just noticing something.
And once again, to quote Batista, weapons are not only welcome, they're allowed.
Oh, that makes...
Ow!
I think that makes my comment much more easier to take.
And you see right now, look at that!
I'm just noticing there's a bit... There's something different about Austin Uhas.
How so?
His hair.
Well, yeah, he's had a haircut. He had that from... Yeah, he had that. I think he was like that in Spain as well. Yeah, it was like that in Spain. But you see right now, Austin got a crossface in!
I never noticed it, till now.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I see right now. Oh, check this out. Boom! Well, it's certainly... I say there's Austin turning it up a gear. And over the head of Phil Meade.
And Phil Meade has been busted open.
Phil Meade has received the cut. Oh!
We got a roll up there.